How do you know if you really want to work and raise your kids, as opposed to being a stay-at-home mom if you have that choice, or being a really active, go-getter career mom who has somebody else completely taking care of your child? It wasn't something that I knew right away, but I'm going to explain to you in this episode of my working mom journey how I figured out the right balance for me. I'm Mocha Mom. Welcome to Working Mom Warrior, where we help you dump the judgment, stop the stress, and feel like a calmer mom as you watch stories of other moms sharing their successes and failures so you can relate to their struggles to juggle career and kids. Now, this time, I am sharing with you my working mom journey, and in this episode, I'm going to explain how I actually decided to be a working mom when my child was a baby, how I found that right balance, and I incorporated all the things in my life that I always knew I wanted to do as a mom. My immediate supervisor was the one I got in touch with and said, hey, I'm gonna come up and bring the baby. And he's like, oh, it'll be great to see you. And so I came up and there's the baby, you know, in his little car seat, and everyone's oohing and aahing. And so I'm having a conversation with my supervisor and he's like, oh, we really miss you. We'd love to see you come back. And I said, that's really sweet. You know, made me feel good that I had been doing good work for them and they valued it. And I said, I loved working here and I do miss it, but I really want to be hands-on with my baby. You know, if I was going to work, I would only want to work like 1 or 2 days a week, especially coming up here. You know, it's such a long commute. And he's like, oh, well, I think we could arrange that. And I always advocate to other women, ask for what you want. You might be surprised. You might get it. Now, in my case, I was definitely lucky. I got it, okay? But I advocate to other women out there, even if you're not so lucky that they say yes, keep trying, keep trying. I wasn't so lucky to get my job in my field when I first applied. It took a long time of, you know, trying over and over and over and getting rejected. So if you really have a work-life balance that you think will be perfect, keep trying to go for that, whether it's in the job you have or even if it means leaving the job you have or the company where you are, where they're very resistant to that. If you love your job and you can find that same job at another company where they might be more open to it, or you might even consider changing your field or your job or whatever if that makes a difference to your work-life balance. And I've actually interviewed several moms who have gone through that career changes specifically because they didn't hate the job they were doing, but they didn't really love it and they didn't want to be away from their kid full time because of that job, and then found another job where they could adjust their hours and do it part time and do it within the hours they wanted. So I liked the hours that I had. I could get up and drive when it wasn't rush hour because I had to drive for 2 hours to another city. And then even though I came back late at night, my husband would be with the baby during that time after the nanny left, and he would have that time to bond with him. And then I would come home when everyone was asleep. And then the next day I'd wake up and have those other 6 days to be with my baby. So eventually, once he was about a year old, I got to the point where I said, you know, I'm ready to add on another day. I liked that time away from him. I loved the time with him, but I liked the time away from him. So I eventually added a second day, and the place where I worked was wonderful because they were open to that. They said, okay, we could put you on the schedule 2 days a week and then have you off the schedule 5 days a week. You know, there might have been an occasion where they said, oh, we really need you extra for this particular week. How about 3 days because we're really short-staffed or something? But they didn't ask me to do that all the time. You have to be careful about that slippery slope. If you're working part-time and then they're constantly asking you to work more, work more, work more, and you're feeling like you're getting away from that work-life balance that works for you, then you got to speak up and say something. But luckily, that never really happened for me. So then when I got pregnant again, I had my daughter about 2.5 years later. Same thing. I was thinking, okay, I'm going to take off a little bit of time, you know, to breastfeed, maybe about the same amount of time with my son. And I did stop driving up there just like before, you know, once I started getting bigger and bigger, probably in about the 7th month. But I intended to come back. And when I did contact them to come back, was that during the recession? No, but they said, okay, the schedule is kind of changing now, And so I think I wanted to come back 2 days a week, but I didn't necessarily right away. We're just gonna have you kind of fill in for a little bit. So I was actually only working like a couple days a month, and I was kind of feeling a little sad about that because I was like, well, I really like that perfect schedule. So even when you get the perfect schedule, it's not like you're necessarily going to be able to like keep it forever just that way. You have to be adaptable. But eventually, you know, once every 2 weeks, then it was once a week, then it was, hey, can you add on another day this week? And then it sort of worked back into 2 days a week. And then I really made it clear I didn't want it to go to 3 days a week. And then it just kind of stayed that way. You know, there were some times during the recession, because I was a freelancer, that they said, you know, budgets are really tight, we're gonna cut back your hours. There was actually like about a year or so in there, year and a half, where they kind of completely took me off the schedule. They didn't say we'd never use you again, but they're like, we just don't have any freelance budget right now. Things are so bad during the recession. And then I really missed my career enough that I went out searching for something else and found a full-time job. But it was a full-time job that was morning hours, and I still felt I could do all the things with my kids that I had been doing, because at that point, my children were in school, I was a room mom, I was an assistant soccer coach, I was a Girl Scout leader, and I was like, okay, I can't do all those things. I knew I couldn't do all those things and work full-time. There may be some moms who can, but like a full-time traditional, you know, 9 to 5, maybe staying 6 or 7 some nights and still making dinner and sitting down with them for dinner every night. So when I found this full-time job that was like, you know, 4 in the morning until noon, I was like, oh, this is perfect. So it lasted for a little while, but for various reasons that were out of my control, it didn't last long term. And eventually I did some other freelance things in the Chicago area, but kept in touch with the station where I had the job that I loved the most, and eventually got back on the schedule there and kind of finished out. And I spent 15 years there. So my working mom journey was really the one that worked for me, working 2 days a week at the job I loved, at a place I loved, and doing it in a way that worked for me 2 days a week, and being the kind of mom I always wanted to be. I was not a Girl Scout leader and a soccer coach and a room mom because I felt like, oh, I have to do this, or it's gonna harm my kids, or I have to do this because, you know, my friends are putting pressure on me or the school's putting pressure on me. I was doing the things that were my vision of being the kind of mom that I always wanted to be. These are things I wanted to do. I loved planning like scavenger hunts for room parties, and I loved doing like birthday parties for my kids with real intricate like activities and stuff. I'm not into like decorations and cooking and all that kind of stuff. I did some of that, but what I was really into was the activities. You know, I'm a high energy person and I like to plan things and I like to come up with all sorts of creative ideas. And so those were the things that I contributed when I did the mom things for my kids' school and my kids' activities. Those were the kinds of things I wanted to do. So I was doing this example of motherhood the way that I wanted, not the way anybody else wanted. And my husband was a very hands-on dad, and everything was going along great. And so I did talk a little about the recession. So that's how things kind of changed in my life. I mean, I don't know, I'm not blaming it on the recession, but what happened was I got to the point where this commute that I used to do from the Chicago area to the Milwaukee area, about 1 hour and 40 minutes, unless there was bad weather or some traffic because of construction. It usually wasn't because of rush hour because I didn't have to go during those times. I would start to hate that commute. I love the job, I love the hours, I love the days, I love the people I work with, but I hate this commute. It just drove me nuts. You know, I'd listen to the radio, I'd listen to music, I'd listen to talk shows, but I just hated it. I just hate driving. I'm the kind of person that I don't like to drive. Some people like get relaxation from driving, I don't. If somebody could drive me around the rest of my life who was safe, I'd be perfectly happy. So I had to come up with a way, and I have a blog post, I think, about this, you know, of how to take something you don't like and turn it into something you like, because it was getting me the means to the end. So I decided, oh, maybe I can listen to audiobooks in the car. So I was in the library just walking up and down the aisles, just looking for something interesting, and I saw this book called Rich Dad, Poor Dad. I had heard of it, but I didn't really know anything about it. And actually, this was after about a year of listening to, at first I was very intentional about what I wanted to listen to. I'm gonna listen to a bunch of biographies about famous journalists, you know, Barbara Walters, and then I listened to a bunch of like historical things, because I never liked history in school, and I sort of had some gaps in my knowledge, you know, Benjamin Franklin and Winston Churchill. And then I just started listening to random things. I did listen to some fiction. I've read some fiction over my life, but I'm not like a big fiction fan. You know, Barbara Kingsolver is one of my favorite authors, and I listen to some of her, but I'm like, I need something that's really of interest to me, and I need to try some different things. You know, I'm always open to trying different things and learning new things. So I'm in the library and I see this book, Rich Dad, Poor Dad, and I'm like, okay. So I start listening to it, and a lot of it is about real estate. And my husband had actually said to me, you know, I've heard of other people who, like, you know, buy houses and rent them out, and it's a way to, you know, kind of have some extra income. And I'm like, we couldn't do that, you know. You have to be handy to do that. And he's like, well, how do you know I'm not handy? And he once told me I was insulting his manhood by telling him he wasn't handy. I'm like, you're great on guitar, but I don't know about fixing things, you know. And so after listening to this book, I realized, okay, you don't have to be this or have to be that. Anybody can get involved in real estate. Actually, you didn't even need a lot of money. You didn't need any money, I learned later. But at the time, my husband's job was enough to pay the bills, and for the first time in our life, have a little extra left over to put aside in savings. It was such a relief. I remember it was a couple years of like actually having enough money to pay all the bills where you didn't have to wait to pay them, like you could pay them when they came, and then after you paid them all, there was still this extra money and you could start a savings account. You know what happens when things are humming along and it seems like everything's almost perfect. There's bound to be a monkey wrench that's thrown in there. So what do you do when something comes along that upsets the balance that you've worked so hard to create? Well, that's what I explain in the next episode of My Working Mom Journey. So check it out, and don't forget to spread a little of your own love to another mom who needs it.